Yeah, honey.
Well, hello, Apple Annie. How are you?
Good.
I'm so glad. What are you up to?
Well, I'm reading.
You're reading? Well, is this the book?
Oh, you can read it.
Okay, I will.
It's for you.
Good, good. Well, are you going to leave it with me? All right. Do you have to pick some more apples? Okay, well, then I guess I'll see you later. All right.
Doodaloo!
Wow, she brought me a book. Wasn't that nice? What's the book about? It says Season Song. Oh, I bet I know why she brought this. Because it has to do with the seasons. And there are four seasons. Summer, spring, summer, fall, and winter. Can you say those with me? Spring, summer, fall, and winter. If you look at the trees change with each season. So since things are changing, I bet that's why she dropped this book by. It's called Season Song. Well, now I need to look at the inside and see what it's all about. Let's see. It is by Marcy Barak, and pictures are by Thierney Corton. Oh, this looks fun. Season Song. Mud, sand, leaves, and snow, sing of seasons as we grow. Sing of spring and slosh in mud, pull apart a flower bud, meet a robin, hang a screen, grab the grass and smell the green. A kitten, watch the rain dripping down the window pane. Spring is when we dig and hoe, planting veggies in a row. This is a fun book. Sing of summer, sprinkle sand, pass a June bug hand to hand. Steer a sailboat, touch the sea, listen to the bumblebee. Pick a berry, romp in shade, pucker up at lemonade. Summer's when we jump and run, chasing bubbles in the sun. Sing of autumn, rolling leaves, tangle with our sleeves. Hug a pumpkin, climb a stool, wave the big kids off to school. Pumpkin fun. Bury bulbs and trace the frost. Search for building blocks we lost. Autumn's when we trick or treat, covered by a big white sheet. Ooh. Sing of winter, stamp in snow, catch a cold and have to blow. Suck on ice and ride a sled, feed the blue jays crumbs of bread. Sometimes you do get sick in the winter time. Hang our jackets on a hook, play piano, read a book. Winter's when we stop to stare at snowflakes drifting in the air. Sing of seasons as we grow, mud, sand, leaves, and snow. That's the four seasons. Let's see if we can say them again. It's spring, summer, fall, and winter. Spring, summer, fall, and winter. Your turn. Spring, summer, fall, and winter. What season is it now? Why, it is fall. Autumn is another name for fall. And that's when we'll see pumpkins and leaves falling down. And we can play in the leaves and make scarecrows, and make a jack-o'-lantern. Wow, there's so many cool things to do, and the colors of fall are just beautiful. Well, I have another story. Can you believe that? But this one wasn't the one I was planning to read to you today. But before I do, since Annie brought the book to us, I thought I'd share my tree so you can see them. This is the springtime tree And I'll put it on my board. Spring. What's next from what we saw? Summer. Oh yeah. Fall, when all the leaves turn colors and it's beautiful, and then they start to fall, and winter. But let's say it one more time. Spring, summer, fall, and winter. Spring, summer, fall, and winter. I'm gonna take all the trees away except for the one that has to do with the season that we have right now, and that's fall. And I have a little poem about fall. It goes like this. When autumn leaves are falling down, they look so beautiful on the ground. Yellow, orange, red, and green, such beautiful colors to be seen. So when you go out, start looking for the leaves to change color, because you'll see some red and yellow and still some green, and they will start to fall to the ground. So what's the story I was going to read today before Annie stopped by? Well, it was about her. I wish I could have told her before she left. It's called There Was an Old Lady Who Swallowed Some Leaves. It's by Lucille Colandra and illustrated by Jared Lee. Now, you see all the leaves? There's a lot of them. There was an old lady who swallowed some leaves. It's like the dog is trying to swallow. Don't do anything she does in the story. There was an old lady who swallowed some leaves. I don't know why she swallowed those leaves. Perhaps she'll sneeze. Well, you can help me with this story as we go. You'll know when I need your help. I'll let you know. There was an old lady who swallowed a shirt. It didn't hurt to swallow that shirt. She swallowed the shirt to fill it with leaves. I don't know why she swallowed the leaves. Perhaps she'll sneeze. That's the part you can help me with. I'll let you know. There was an old lady who swallowed a pumpkin. She wasn't a bumpkin to swallow that pumpkin. She swallowed the pumpkin to wear the shirt. She swallowed the shirt to fill it with leaves. I don't know why she swallowed the leaves. Help me. Perhaps she'll sneeze. And remember to cover up your sneeze. There was an old lady who swallowed a pole. She was on a roll when she swallowed that pole. I don't know. She swallowed the pole to prop up the pumpkin. She swallowed the pumpkin to wear the shirt. She swallowed the shirt to fill it with leaves. I don't know why she swallowed the leaves. Perhaps she'll sneeze. There was an old lady who swallowed some pants. She started to dance when she swallowed the pants. Can you dance? Ooh. She swallowed the pants to cover the pole. She swallowed the pole to prop up the pumpkin. She swallowed the pumpkin to wear the shirt. She swallowed the shirt to fill it with leaves. I don't know why she swallowed the leaves. Perhaps she'll sneeze. There was an old lady who swallowed a rope. She didn't mope when she swallowed that rope. She swallowed the rope to tie up the pants. She swallowed the pants to cover the pole. She swallowed the pole to prop up the pumpkin. She swallowed the pumpkin to wear the shirt. She swallowed the shirt to fill it with leaves. I don't know why she swallowed the leaves. Perhaps she'll sneeze. There was an old lady who swallowed some hay. She didn't say why she swallowed that hay. But she did it with ease. And then she started to sneeze. Oh my goodness. Everything is coming out that she swallowed. My happy fall. Oh, all those things made something funny. It's a scarecrow. Now, if you were listening closely, you might know all the things that I mentioned in my story. Don't be like the old lady who swallowed some leaves and tried to do that yourself. Bad news. Don't do that. It's a silly story about Annie, but Annie really couldn't do all that or she'd get sick. And that would be terrible. You just can't do it. But it is fun to read. So let's see what you remember. I have this little face of Annie. And I'm gonna see if you can remember what she swallowed first. There was an old lady who swallowed some, did you say leaves? You are right, and look what I have here. I have some leaves, and I'm gonna let her eat them. You ready? Woo! That was pretty funny. What did she swallow next? Was it a pumpkin? Or I know there was a pole, and then there was some hay and some pants, and I think it was a shirt. Did you guess shirt? You are right. Here is my shirt. Let's see if she can swallow that. Ready? She did it. What comes next? Is it the pole, the pumpkin, or the hay? I think it was the pumpkin. Did you say pumpkin? If you did, you are right. It's a pumpkin. Can she swallow that? It's a lot of stuff in there. What's next? Let's see, I have pants and some hay. What did she swallow next? I think it was pants. Do you think it was pants? Okay, let's try it. Oh my goodness. And what's next? A rope? A pole? I think I got it wrong. I think she swallowed the pole first. I'm getting my P words mixed up. Oh my goodness. Let's get that in there. The pole is in. So it was first the pole, then the pants. Oh my goodness, there's three P words. Pumpkin, pole, and pants. Pumpkin, pole, and pants. Now what's left? I have a rope and some hay. I put it in a bag so it wouldn't be so messy. I'm gonna feed her the rope. If that's right, I think I'll put it in. Do you agree? It is. Put the rope in. Oh my goodness. I don't know if she can get all this in her. And the last thing we have is some hay. I'll put it in. There you go. And when she ate all that, what happened next? Choo! And everything came floating out. And what did it make? A scarecrow! Happy fall! That was a funny story. Well, since we talked about four seasons, I thought it would be really good to talk about a number today. And the number is, I'll write it for you. The number four. Let's see if I can make that again. I'm going to go down and over, down and over and down. It didn't show up. It looks like a plus sign. Let's see if I turn it this way, if that's easier. Down, over, down. That's four. Some people make a four this way. That's not the better way. You might see it in books that way, but this is the best way. I'm gonna do this again, get the magic and erase it, and we'll go down, over, down. It looks like an L with a line through it. Now, how many is four? Well, I'll hold up four fingers. One, two, three, four. Can you hold up four fingers? One, two, three, four. I'm gonna make four circles. One, two, three, four. That's four circles. Well, I have four things that are things of fall or autumn. Let's see what they look like. I have one apple, the two with corn that grew all summer and now it's time to pick. It's called harvest. I have three, a pumpkin, and four, a scarecrow. So it's one, two, three, and four. Now I have some little baby pumpkins that I have here. And I want you to try to help me find the group of four. So I'm going to move this so that you can see my little pumpkins. And there they are. So which one is a group of four? I have lines to divide them. Look closely, remember. One, two, three, four. Let's check out, is this one four? Let's count. One, two, three, four, five. No, that's a five, that's not four. Which ones are four? Let's see. Do you see one that you think could be four? Could this one be four? The one that's next to it? Well, one, two, three, four. That is four. If you found that one, it's right. I'm gonna put a little check mark there. That one has four. Next, does this one have four? Let's count. One, two, three, four. Why, it does have four. That's another one. So I'm gonna put a little check mark. Let's go to the next row. Is that a group of four? Let's count. One, two, three, four. It is four, another one. So we'll put a little check mark. Let's move over. There's the numeral 4. Down, over, down. Let's count. 1, 2, 3. No, that's not a group of 4. How about down here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, that's not a group of 4. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's another group of 4. Wow. So far, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 groups of 4. Now let's see. Is this a group of 4? Yes. Or no, I don't know. We have to count. 1, 2, 3, 4. It is. But if I want to only have 4 groups of 4, I'm going to do this. I'm going to move one. And let's see if I changed it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I did. So I did have 5 groups of 4, but I changed it. So I would have only 4 groups of 4. This is 1 group of 4, 2 group of 4, 3 group of 4, and 4 groups of 4. And that's our number. Now another thing, I have another poem for you. It's about something that grows on the farm all summer and then it's time to pick. This is my pumpkin. And we can do a little poem that goes like this. I have in here some friends. Let me see if I can get them out. Where are you? I don't see you. Here we go. Peter, Peter, pumpkin eater, had a wife and couldn't keep her. So he put her in a pumpkin shell and there he kept her very well. Well, I think they have a lovely looking house, don't you? Could you say this with me? It goes, Peter, Peter, pumpkin eater, had a wife and couldn't keep her. So he put her in a pumpkin shell and there he kept her very well. Now, I have one more thing that we're going to look at for the season of fall. I have my board and I have this board and I'm going to try to make a pattern with these fall things. Let's see if you can help me figure this out. So, I'm going to start with an apple. Apples can be 3 different colors. Red, yellow, and green. So, I'm going to pick one. I'm going to have to put this down here. And I'll start with a red apple. So I have red apple, green apple, red apple. What would come next in the pattern? It would be a green apple. What would be next? It's a red apple. Let's do the pattern together. Red apple, green apple, red apple, green apple, red apple. What's next? A green apple. Now I can take some of these and I can move them down here. Let's try another pattern. I'll do it this way. Red, yellow, green. Red, yellow, green. What comes next? Red, yellow, or green? Look at the pattern, start here. Red, yellow, green. Red, yellow, green. What will be next? If you said red, you are right. It is red. Then what? Yellow or green? What do you think, Jelly Bean? It is Yellow. If you said yellow, you are right out of sight. And what's left? Well, we'll put Mr. Green down here. So there you have red, yellow, green, red, yellow, green, red, yellow, green. So we can have another pattern. I can do this. I'll move all of these and I can go red apple, acorn. Those are two A words. Acorn and apple are both A words. One is the long sound of A, the other's the short sound of A. Let's see what I can do. So I will go red apple, red apple, acorn. What would be next? I have red apple, red apple, and what would be next? Well, if you said acorn, you are right. You are right. There are some patterns that we have. Now you can set, you can do patterns with words too. So let's see if I can try this. If I said apple, apple has two parts. It's a two clap word. Apple. Can you do that with me? Apple. Yes. That's a two clap word. Let's try another one. This is acorn. And that's a two clap word. Acorn. Acorn. Now let's look at the apple and look at the color. And that is red. How many claps would that be? Red. That's a one clap word. So red apple. Red apple. Red apple. Red apple. Red apple. We made a pattern with words. How cool is that? This is green. How many claps do you think would be in green? Green. It's a one clap. Green. One clap. How many claps are in pumpkin? Pumpkin. Pumpkin. So that's a two clap word. Pumpkin. So I have pumpkin, green. Pumpkin, green. Let's try that if we clap it. Pumpkin, green. Pumpkin, green. Or we can go green, pumpkin, green, pumpkin. You can make a pattern with the words. So to end today, I'm going to show you the signs of autumn, which is another name for fall. And it says, count the signs of autumn. Since we were counting today, let's count. One apple treat tastes so sweet. Two warm socks on my feet. Three red leaves go drifting by. Four monarchs flying in the sky. Five big pumpkins grin at me. What signs of autumn will you see? Let's try that one more time. One apple treat tastes so sweet. You could pretend to make an apple. Two warm socks on my feet. My feet. Two warm socks on my feet. Three red leaves go drifting by. You can do that with your hands. Three red leaves go drifting by. Four monarchs flying in the sky. And Four monarchs flying in the sky. That would be a butterfly. Five big pumpkins grin at me. What signs of autumn will you see? Go out and look for your signs of autumn. Watch for the trees to change. And I'll see you next time. Bye.